This is Average Joe PT, and on this episode, we're going to talk about the knee. Specifically, we're going to talk about, did you tear your meniscus or didn't you? We're going to go over treatment techniques, we're going to go over the surgery to actually repair this, or to take that damaged tissue out. So, stick around, here we go. Now, when we're talking about the knee itself, it really is made up of two real main joints. It's made of your femur bone, and it's made of your tibia or your shin bone. And it has a little bone off of here on the side, it's fibula. But when we open up the knee, and we pull back the side, we'll pull away from that kneecap for a second, and we really see, in this representation of the meniscus, is these blue things right here. These are what gets torn when we have either a fall, or maybe we step on something that's really tall, or we get hit from the side, maybe a car accident, a football game, you know, pickup game, just kind of, you know, messing around, horsing it up, so to speak, and that can actually cause the meniscus to tear, because those meniscus really make this bone and this bone work together with one another. And when this knee bends or straightens out, then those little blue meniscus in there, they float around on the top of this shin bone, and that knuckle, if there's a tear in there and we go ahead and straighten that out, it's going to catch on that. Now that's going to give you radiating pain, it's going to get inflamed, it's going to swell up, and all of a sudden you can barely move this knee. Those are all protective mechanisms for this knee. Now, the first thing you want to do treatment-wise is get off of the knee, ice it, compression and elevation. The tough part is where did you tear that meniscus? Now, there's a couple tests we can do in the clinic to basically show you how, is it torn, is it not torn? The gold standard is an MRI. So that doctor's gonna do a few tests just like we would do in the clinic, and I'll show you those right there. And then afterwards, like, okay, we gotta get an MRI because I think there actually might be a tear in there. Where is that tear located at? There's several different types of tear depending on the type and style of tear that's in there or the injury itself. Now, if you're on the outer part of that meniscus, you can actually repair that knee without any surgery at all. The body has enough blood flow on that outside of that meniscus. But once you get starting into the center of that knee joint itself, blood flow is gone and we're really only nourished by synovial fluid. And then at that point, if it's a tear is bad enough, you're gonna have to have this surgery that I'm gonna show you right now. And that surgery really will help so this knee doesn't catch again when we go to bend and straighten that knee out again. So I want you guys to stick around. I got a few more things like I always try and show you in this regard to the meniscus to see if do you have a tear or don't you. So stay tuned. I'm gonna give you four things that you need to worry about and if you think you have a meniscal tear. Four things are this. Number one, biggest one, if it feels like your knee is catching. What I mean by that, it feels like every time you go to bend or straighten that knee, it feels like it catches or wants to lock in place. If it feels like your knee is completely straight and it won't bend, immediately go see the doctor because you probably have a meniscal tear. If it seems like it catches for a few days and feels better, swelling starts and then it starts to go away, but then the symptoms after maybe a week or so, they come right back again, you probably have a meniscal tear. If it feels like you can't even put weight on it, or otherwise it gives you sharp shearing pain, or if you can't pivot or twist on that, then you'll probably have a meniscal tear. Those are the huge signs and symptoms that it's not arthritis. It's not a tendon or tendonitis or bursitis. More than likely, you have a meniscal tear and you need to see your doctor. So I wanted you to stick around a few more seconds for me. I'm going to go over just a few treatment techniques that you can go ahead and do to hopefully help reduce your pain. So stay tuned. Treatment number one, ice is the best thing you can do when you have any type of tear. It's reducing inflammation, it's reducing pain, and it's reducing swelling. Those are three huge things that we need to hopefully get this knee to calm down quickly and hopefully get you to recover faster. Treatment number two, this position right here, about 30 degree bend. That bend right there is the most important piece because it's the largest space that you're gonna give your knee joint and hopefully help reduce some of the pain that you're having. Last but not least, number three, is put some pillows or towels underneath and really unload that joint so it's not feeling like it wants to straighten out. Those are some major treatment techniques that you can do at home. And like I said earlier, if you have any of those types of symptoms, you want to immediately go to the doctor. Now, if you guys are new to this channel, Scully's head's falling off here a little bit. He's been sad lately, so I haven't let him talk too much. But if you guys are new to this channel, I'd love to have you subscribe. I bring treatment techniques two or three times a week in those videos. And until next time, I want you to look up and keep smiling. See you next time, folks.